Welcome, staff, parents, and students. We finally made it. Despite being put through a very confusing year and an extended, isolated summer, we are here, in person, standing together to celebrate one of life's greatest milestones, high school graduation. I remember when I first entered Stivers School for the Arts as a seventh grader. You could see that everyone was trying to get a real good feel for the school and how to become comfortable in the new environment. I was very introverted, and I didn't know how to talk to people when they approached me. My hair added to the suspense because nobody could see my face, and it became a very iconic part of my identity. As I entered high school, I was struck with an overwhelming amount of information. I remember attending a freshman orientation in early August and catching up with some of my classmates. None of us knew how much change was yet to come. As my freshman year began, I recall listening to Two by Lil Uzi Vert from his freshly dropped album, Love Is Rage 2, an album many in my class would consider a classic. This song set the tone for my entire high school career. Fast forwarding to today, the class of 2021 is now filled with innovation and creativity, and I say this in the most humble way possible. That's the main word I would use to describe my class, humble. We have an overwhelming amount of intelligence and a very limited way of expressing such a gift. Through exams and classwork is where the magic lies for the students sitting here before me. Along with the inventive spirit and abstract thoughts you can only capture through conversing. I believe my generation has a lot to offer to the future of technology and even the world. I want to take time to give thanks to my mom, Ronnie, who raised me from the littlest graduate. Who raised me from the littlest graduate to a high school graduate. She has always led by example and showed me the power of resilience and optimism. I would also like to thank my stepdad, Bob, who taught me the power of silence and self-work. Seeing the amount of times where it looked like we were all out of luck, they proved to me time and time again that resilience cannot be defeated, and with the right mindset, any obstacle can be overcome. I love y'all very much. Throughout high school, we've encountered many different passionate teachers who have helped us along the way. As freshmen, many of us had Mr. Coffin, a bright, energetic, and ecstatic teacher who made even our cloudiest days eventful and fun. Or maybe you have Ms. Daniels, the math wizard. A teacher who intimidates you at first as you are told, don't take your time. When practicing problems on your own, and she grew to become someone you could hear as you attack every math problem put in front of you from start to finish. These are only two of the many different faces that greeted us every day, and our success wouldn't be possible without the tremendous amount of help you all have provided for us. I want to welcome everyone again to the graduation ceremony for the class of 2021. Which was long overdue. And as your friendly neighborhood Spider-Man once said, anyone can win a fight when the odds are even. It's when the going gets tough, when there seems to be no chance, that's when it counts. And we made it count.
When this class first entered Stivers, we could have easily be considered a relatively normal group of students, at least compared to others in our school. We worked hard at projects, prepared for concerts, were eager to progress in our magnet classes, and centered our lives around our friends. While we were focused on school, our teachers saw our potential and told us our generation would be the one to finally change the world. From our perspectives, though, we were too small and too disconnected from the outside world to fully understand our place in it. The summer of 2019 was a period of tragedy in our city. The events of the Memorial Day tornadoes and of the Oregon District shooting focused the eye of the nation on Dayton. When we returned to Stivers that fall, it was clear that things felt different. We were all given an orange wristband emblazoned with the name of our school and the phrase Dayton Strong. And we were told by our magnet directors that the only way things would begin to return to normal was to have faith for a better future. Of course, we didn't know it at the time, but that was only the beginning of what would come to be the most impactful 2 years of our lives. We, the class of 2021, are like no other class that has had the privilege of standing on this field. While we have still faced the typical struggles of middle and high school students, we have been through much more than other generations have had to witness. Our first-hand experience of multiple historical events has changed how we see ourselves in the world. We have chosen to immerse ourselves in stories of the world's injustices because we now know that we are a part of it. In 2018, we stood in the soccer field in memoriam of 17 high schoolers like us who lost their lives in Parkland. In 2019, we were resolute as multiple tornadoes wreaked havoc on our city, and only a little more than a month later, as the Oregon District tragedy took place only a few blocks away from our school. In March of last year, we braced for change as we were thrust out of our routines, out of our comforts, and out of our Stivers home. And as weeks of uncertainty turned to months of instability, our attention was quickly drawn to other matters. Protests across the country erupted in waves throughout the summer and into the fall and winter, calling for justice and systemic reform after the killings of Breonna Taylor, Ahmaud Arbery, George Floyd, Cornelius Frederick, Daniel Prude, and so many other black lives, as well as countless other people of color wronged by our justice system. I still wear my orange wristband, although at this point its color is faded and a small tear has appeared above the N in Strong. Every time I put it on, I am reminded that despite each menace that has threatened to tear us down, we have continued to persevere. Our magnet director's words still hold true. Faith in a better future is indeed the key to carrying ourselves through tragedy. But we must not strive for return to normalcy. The status quo is wrought with inequity and prejudice that must be corrected. We must instead pursue a better world. And faith alone is not how change takes root. It is our voices and our actions that make a difference. We know this because we have demonstrated it. We have not stood idly by as injustices have taken hold of our world. In 2017, students, like Sophie Johnson, led an effort to send aid and supplies to Puerto Rico after the devastation of Hurricane Maria.
It was students that marched and rallied throughout Dayton to advocate for gun reform after the Parkland shooting. In the wake of the Memorial Day tornadoes, students volunteered their time to help restore what they could of the impacted areas. And throughout the past year, many students, like Anna Walker, Hannah Bradshaw, and Jaya Jones, have been intimately involved in organizing and participating in protests, marches, and demonstrations for racial justice. We have been told time and time again that it is our generation that can and must finally change the world. And we know it is possible because we have done it before. We have already taken necessary steps to make it better, from volunteering in our city to rallying for legislative reform, to raising our voices for what we know is right. But we still have so much farther to go. We have learned so much from all our teachers here at Stivers, like how to support our claims with valid evidence, how to take initiative to get difficult tasks done, and of course, how to use our arts to make our opinions heard. It is now time to use the skills they have given us, as well as the change-driven perspectives we have adopted, in full force to change the world as we were told we must do. Class of 2021. It has been a sincere honor to learn and grow alongside you for these past six years. We have grown into a uniquely bold and tight-knit coalition of leaders, innovators, and revolutionaries. I will continue to proudly wear my orange wristband, and it will remind me of every moment we have witnessed, every change we have sought to make, and every lesson we have learned. And now, as we face a future in a world we can and must improve, it is more important than ever to remember what we've learned. We must keep faith that we can one day live in a better future. And we must take action to bring that future into existence. Thank you.
Thank you for making me laugh, Sid. my beautiful best friend, Layla King. Who lets me borrow bobby pins when I forget them for dance class, and brings extra cheeses on long rehearsal days. I love you, buddy. From Jaya Jones and her breathtaking spoken word, to Juan Maya and his lunchtime games of Uno, the class of 2021 is unapologetically themselves. We are products of our environment, influenced by teachers who are equally as unique as their students. Miss Roche, you wear a lab coat almost every day, and you once named all the cranial bones off the top of your head. You are who I want to be when I grow up. Mr. Higginbotham, from the Jared Diamond shrine behind your computer to the ill-proportioned dinosaur painting that decorates your classroom. Thank you for the fun-loving energy you bring to teaching. Ms. Underwood, you taught me how to sew a button and how to read Shakespeare. You call your students sweet chickens. I adore you. I know only the dancers had you as a teacher, but somehow every senior still knows your name. I admire that about you, and I admire how you shaped me into the hard worker I am. There were many days over the past 6 years when a ballet bar was the absolute last thing I wanted to do, but you have a way of inspiring me even when it seems impossible. The work ethic you helped me grow is the only reason I get to call myself salutatorian. Mr. Reisner, when I had you in 8th grade, you taught me that speaking up in class doesn't have to be scary. When I took your class as a senior, you couldn't get me to shut up. Thank you for believing in me. Ms. Daniels, as your student, my love for math grew exponentially. You somehow get even the cool kids to wear math-themed t-shirts. I will miss you and the pizza you always provide. Mr. Unger, you teach government, which going into senior year, I thought would be my least favorite subject. Now that being said, by March, you had me rushing into class to hear one more of your stories. You spread wisdom to younger generations as if it were an easy task. And the class of 2021 will always be thankful for you. Lastly, I'd like to thank my first ever teachers. Mama, you drove me to school for 4 years. You made me countless peanut butter and banana wraps. And you weren't even mad at me when I gave you coronavirus. Dad, you proofread every important paper I wrote throughout high school. You paid for every magnet fee, and you wordsmithed every paragraph in this speech except this one. I hope I make you proud enough to pay for college. I auditioned for this school because I love to dance. The staff and students at Stivers School for the Arts made me realize the one thing I love more than dancing, learning. In the words of Nelson Mandela, education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. Class of 2021, it is up to us to change the world for the better. To my peers, know that wherever your life takes you next, there are people rooting for you, and I'm one of them. So don't get out your notes, because high school's over. But as Ms. Daniels says, we're moving on. Thank you.
Superintendent Dr. Lally, board members Spencer Reinhardt, Chief Dooley, and Chief Payton, and distinguished guests on stage. my assistant principal, Adrian Jackson, our magnet coordinator, Elizabeth Whip, academic coach, Megan Mippen, senior advisor, Teresa Sorrell, counselor, David Ace Adorn, the great staff of Stivers School for the Arts, parents, family members, and friends of the class of 21. Good morning. I want to thank the parents personally for the opportunity to work with your son or your daughter. It wasn't a pleasure, extreme pleasure. I want to thank the wonderful class for their many accomplishments and the leadership through this most challenging year. My sincere wish for luck, success, and happiness for this class of 2021. Superintendent Lally, I hereby certify that the students here today have met or exceeded the requirements set forth by the Ohio Department of Education and the Dayton Public Schools. Each student has earned a minimum of 20.5 Carnegie units in the required courses. Dr. Lally, it is with great pleasure that I present to you for your acceptance, the Stivers School for the Arts, Class of 2021. The Class of Classes.
Good morning. I am so happy to be here today. This has been an uncertain, challenging year, but we made it. One thing is certain, these young people we celebrate today have shown the resilience, the grit, the determination, and effort through each and every challenge to arrive here today. They are headed for success. Congratulations. As superintendent of the Dayton City Schools, and by the powers entrusted to me by the Ohio Department of Education and the Dayton Board of Education, I do by here accept these candidates for graduation and release their diplomas to be presented at this ceremony. Board Member Spencer Reinert, it is my honor to present to you the Stivers School for the Arts Class of 2021.
Hello to all administrators, parents, and graduates. On behalf of the Dayton Board of Education, I would like to extend my sincere congratulations to the Stivers School for the Arts Class of 2021. This school year has not been like any other year before it. You've adapted your lives to many changes in a very short amount of time. From logging in home to attend school, to wearing a mask throughout the school day, to keeping your distance from your peers and teachers, and even playing sports with only a few family members in the stands to cheer you on, this year has certainly been difficult for you and your family at some point. Despite the difficulties, there have been many triumphs. This year, as COVID protocols changed endlessly, you proved that you could adapt to any situation, to make the most of it and succeed. As the pandemic worsened and left us with more questions than answers about the future, you still showed up every day and put in the work to ensure your future and ensure that it would be bright no matter what. As the world began to open back up, you returned to in-person classes and finished out the year strong, despite the changes it brought to your life once again. You kept going despite all of these challenges and changes that no one ever before had experienced. There was no one to offer advice because no one ever had been in your shoes. You kept going despite all of these challenges and changes that no one before you had ever experienced. There was no one to offer you advice. Throughout everything, you proved that you are determined, self-motivated, creative, and capable of solving any problem put before you. You are truly resilient and strong, which is not a skill that can be simply taught. Be proud of that, and for all of that you have accomplished this year, because we are proud of all of you. I would now like to take a moment to share a few highlights from the Stivers School for the Arts class of 2021. Students earned a combined $12.1 million in scholarships. Eric Charlton received a full ride scholarship to the University of Dayton. And Cordell Burris earned a full ride scholarship to Ohio University. Ian Fitzgerald was awarded the American Visions Medal and was recognized at Carnegie Hall for his entry in the National Scholastic Arts and Writing Awards. Zora Bodie placed fourth in the 300 meter hurdles at the state championship track meet. Marley Harris had perfect attendance throughout all 4 years of high school. And the U.S. News and World Report once again ranked Stivers as the second best high school in the area. Now, on behalf of the Dayton Board of Education, I accept these students commended to me by the superintendent, and they shall be hereforth deemed graduates of Dayton Public Schools. And they shall be hereforth bestowed with all of the rights, privileges, and responsibilities afforded to graduates of this school system. I wish you success in everything your future has in store for you. As you move into the next chapter of your life, please remember to carry with you the skills and knowledge that you took from your time as a DPS student. Please also remember that your Dayton Public Schools family will always be here to support you. And please don't mind your parents and guardians' tears today. Now, please join me in congratulating the Stivers School for the Arts class of 2021.
Peter Spencer Reinard. Lindsay Catherine Rowland. Michaela Renee Fleming. Sophia Scarlett Johnson. Gabriel Paul Gray. Julianne Marie Moreland. Jasmine Leahi Lacuna. Raynard Andrew Samuel Despain. Xin Yu Zhang. Brooklyn Julianne Maria Watts. Jameson Tyler Lauer. Sydney Nicole Blay. Laylee Jordan King. Amaya Mikkel Johnson. Jaya Jones. Antonio James Aubrey. Amna Abbas Ahmed. Kayla Amari Alexander. Jordan Diana Angelia Anderson. Farida Aslanova. Ava Marie Arnold. Sherlina Lynn Baker. Andresha Brene Barker. Alyssa Michelle Backburn. Zora Sinquenese Body. Tasia Janae Bolian. Hannah Grace Bradshaw. Savannah Joanne Brantley. Michael Leasia Bryce. Janelle Star Bright. Sky Brene Bristow. Kaya Marley Brugman. Cordell Elton Burris. Avalyn Rainey Cheney. Eric D'Allen Charlton. Tayshawn David Cheeks. Sincere Deshae Cole. Carly June Klaus. Colleen Laura Krupe. Johnny Lee Davis the Fourth. Wesley Davis. Mariah Chanel Dixon. Francis Julia Dunlap. Crystal Ann Dunn. Sanaya Monet Eubank Campbell. Samaya Gabrielle Levater Evans. Amaru Sunday Everett. Mitchell Robert Fine. Ian Michael Fitzgerald. Brooklyn Alana Frizzell. Marquise Lynn Gamblin. James DeAndre Glenn. Addison Olivia Godsey. Jade Alexis Godot. Marcos Alexander Gray. Avery Nicole Green. Selah Marie Griffin. Amarie Lachey Hall. Amber Rose Brooke Hansford. Marley Mikkel Harris. Miracle Lynn Yvonne Harris. Armand Nico Harrison. Leonard Darnell Hurd Jr. Rodney Sean Henderson Jr. Lillian Elizabeth Higgins. Mariah Young Hill. Azariah Robert Lee Holbrook. Myron Lindsay Hollingsworth. Tanea Brianna Holmes. Thomas Michael Howard. Shanice Monet Hunter. Rihanna Lachey Jackson. Benjamin Grant Johnson. Classy Renee Johnson. Lily Rose Johnson. Chase Destiny Jones. Christina Darlene Jones. LaKennethy Claudine Jones. Nylea Morgan Jones. Zoe Malaya Jones. Claire Patience Kenyatta. Aiden Michael Kesson. Raymond James King Redding. Sabrina Renee Kinsler. Carolyn J. Liu. Destiny Vastai Love. Amelia Chanel Martin. Tiana Ann Matthews. Juan Pablo Maya. Macy Ray Ann McGee. Viree Tavon McQuay. Sophia Messer Ansalaco. Riley Michael Kate Mickey. Hunter Moffitt. Ariana Isabel Mulakey. Tessa Rayon Mullins Troutman. Malika Mustalova. Shelby Nicole Newthman. Nolan Brian O'Hara. Eliana Catherine Papadis. Stephanie Ann Francis Patton. Anaya Muani Payne. Justice Jolene Payne. Aaliyah Yasmin Piegler. JC Makaya Phipps. Oliver Romeo Pierce. James Clarence Pippard. Jude Elliott Powell. Montana Amaya Pruitt. Jaden Lou Quarles. Katie Quintuna. Tone Catherine Reddick. Alicia Grace Roos. Jayla Marie Robinson. Kennedy Amarion Monet Sane. Sydney Marie Sampson. Mariamu B. Safanu. Madison Alexandra Smith. Kira Nicole Stahl. Brooklyn May Textor. Jermaine M. Tinsley. Brielle Angie Lene Twitty. Serena DeVay Uloho. Christian Dariel Valdez Mendiola. Anna Marie Walker. Lily Catherine Walters. Jayana Alexandra Ware. Jonathan Bradley Waymeyer. Elise Nalene Weaver. Leani Monet Webb. Chanel Makisha White. Margaret Whitmer. Sophia Allen Wiley. Ariana Tashawn Williams. Joy Lachey Williams. Grace Ann Wilson. Brooklyn Alexis Wortham. Belu Alim Yaka. I'm waiting on the senior who is going to exercise the turning of the tassels. Ladies and gentlemen, honored guests, family and friends, cherished alumni, we are happy you're here today. It is my privilege and honor to present to you the Stivers School for the Arts graduating 2021 class. Congratulations.
Class of 2021, this is it. The last curtain call, the last brush stroke, the last word written. Let's cherish this moment all together for possibly the last time. As we prepare ourselves to leave behind the art-filled hallways that has been our place of refuge, our sanctuary, our home for the past 6 years. We must take with us the amazing memories that will dwell in our hearts and minds as we venture into the next chapter in our lives. We must remember to thank our mentors, our teachers, like Mr. Unger. Ms. Neisinger, Mr. Reisner, Ms. Underwood, Mr. Hopkins, and many others. Our parents, my mom Kimya, my dad Craig, who have put in counseling hours and dedication to make sure that we've made it to this very moment despite the events of the past year. COVID, riots and protests, starting our senior year in our homes, staring at laptop screens. But in that experience are the lessons that were gifted to us. Lessons of strength, kindness, courage, creativity, and most of all, hope. So as we depart from our Stivers home to find anew, as we drift different directions into our own personal journeys, we must take with us these five lessons that all great leaders, both past and present, had to learn. One, we must remember to do what's in front of us. Tony Hall. When we bear witness to something unjust, something that isn't right, we are the ones who stand up and say something about it, do something about it, even if we have to do it alone, and show off our awareness of current issues plaguing our society, and have both the kindness and understanding to come at those situations with a different angle. Like seeing someone in need and being the ones to step up to help them and being at their side. Two, remember to do what you have to do by any means necessary. Malcolm X, with our unmatchable strength and determination, we will do not only what we can, but what we must do to knock down all obstacles standing in our way, to overcome them no matter how great the situation proves to be. Three, we must be willing to get into trouble, good trouble. John Lewis. We must be willing to make sacrifices for what we believe, to be courageous in the face of chaos and injustice, like when many of us put our voices and our bodies on the line for the justice of Breonna Taylor and George Floyd. Four, you can't use up creativity. The more you use, the more you have. Maya Angelou. In our darkest days, we are the ones to let the light in and do what we here as Stivers are known for, using our hands, our voices, our never-ending imagination to create, creating something beautiful, relatable, extraordinary, all for the betterment of the world around us. Like when we all use our talents in aid of the Black Lives Matter movement in summer of 2020. Five. And finally, we should all remember that hope is that thing inside us that insists, despite all evidence to the contrary, that something better awaits us if we have the courage to reach for it and to work for it and to fight for it. Barack Obama. The class of 2021 is best known as the class of hope and perseverance for pushing through when the going gets tough, and we have always prevailed. It is our hope that allows us to do so, and it will be our hope that will always allow us to succeed. These five lessons are what make up the fighting spirit, the Stivers spirit, the class of 2021 spirit. And with this, the world will know that you can never lose. We will never lose. It has truly been an honor to laugh, cry, and grow alongside you, class of 2021. We have given our best performance. Thank you.